Welcome to IT Chronicles 10 in Tech. I'm Carlos Casanova. We're here at Knowledge 17 with my co-host Shane Carlson.
Hello.
And Dan Ortega from Blazent.
Hey,
welcome,
Carlos.
Dan. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
So Dan, you know, we've had a few of these sessions over the last few years. I know.
Third one,
yeah. So we've been seeing a lot of great stuff coming from you guys, and obviously the industry's continuing to expand. Tell us a little bit about how you guys are playing into that, you know, the digital transformation and data quality and, you know, basically everything that's going on with IoT, all sorts of stuff.
So we've been very active in the ITSM space from a data quality perspective for quite a while. And what's happening is, the industry changes, the technology framework is always shifting. So we're seeing a lot of shift right now from ITSM into ITOM.
Right.
Right, which I've always thought of ITSM as a subset of ITOM anyway.
Yeah.
It's a natural expansion, right? And so when you get into the operational side of the equation, then you're dealing with more things, right? Because it's operational management. IT is kind of a separate information silo. Operations management deals with the technology associated with things that make the business run,
right?
So yeah. It could be tractors, it could be for governments, it could be stoplights or parking meters, it could be literally anything. It's a thing, right? So what we're finding is the whole framework is shifting. It's expanding very rapidly. So there's this confluence that's going on between IT and OT, right? Because of the natural evolution of the way technology works. So what we're seeing is a big increase in the range of items that are being tracked and managed that can be used as a part of a data quality framework to be able to build a better basis for making decisions.
Wow.
That makes sense.
It's something we're very active in right now.
Yeah. So what are you guys doing at Blazent right now? There's a lot of things coming through, a lot more data being stored in customers' environments and a lot more parts of the business than just IT. Bringing a lot of those financial assets, you mentioned stoplights and other things. How are you guys helping businesses beyond IT tackle some of the financial and data quality aspects of their asset data?
So part of it is, data quality is basically a point in time. It's an item, a configuration item in the CMDB, right? Data integrity is tracking information as it flows across the enterprise, right? So any business, whether you process mortgages or manufacture cars, there's a start and a stop, and you go through multiple steps, and every step is fueled by data, right? But the transformation of that data as it moves through the process, it's very critical to keep the integrity of the process, because you can start out with high quality at one end, and then suddenly something happens, and you get two conflicting sources coming in and saying, it's not that, it's this, and suddenly the integrity starts to shift, and then everything downstream starts to wobble. So our focus is on making sure that our customers are able to track the quality, the integrity of the data that attaches itself to the process as it moves through the whole enterprise workflow.
Yeah. Are you finding some of your larger customers, let's say some of the MSIs, MSPs, the bigger companies who have a lot of different customers themselves, do you find they're getting a lot of value out of the Blazent platform in terms of managing data across large subsets of customers? Or are they seeing some efficiencies there? Or?
Well, the biggest play that we're seeing with the MSPs and the MSIs is being able to accurately track billing.
Yeah.
Because they provide the service, it's gigantic. And the thing is, one of two things happens. You either underbill, money on the table, or you overbill, clawback. Yeah. Neither one, pretty scenario. So
none are good.
We can level this out, and the customers that we've done this for, the MSPs, have actually had, it's like 6 to 8 figure savings.
That's good.
It's
especially
noticeable.
To have the predictability, across that account is good too, because I know that's the variability from month to month, asset to asset, tends to create a lot of havoc there.
Well, nobody likes surprises, whether you're the provider or the customer. Right. So this kind of levels the playing field, and everybody comes out, a lot happier.
Perfect.
And it seems like, like you said, it's an expansion from the ITSM to the ITOM, but in principle, it's not like you're doing a lot anything really different. So you've got years of history in doing it in one space. Data is data.
Yeah.
It's just the application of it. It seems like so you're taking really the years of experience and just applying them in a much broader space now.
Yeah. The definition of data has changed, because before a thing was a server.
Right.
Now it's a wristwatch.
Right.
Before it was a router. Now it can be something in a car that tracks with the movement of the car. So, and you're seeing this now, it's the whole technology has kind of, the Internet of Things thing is hitting really fast and really hard because it's convenient.
Yes.
Yeah. They're pushing out cars now that drive themselves and pick you up. And, it's like for an aging population, this is huge.
Yeah.
Right. So there's all kinds of stuff that's going on like this now. So it's, as far as we're concerned, if it's a thing that's got an IP address and it can be tracked, it's a configuration item, and that's what we track. So, self-driving car or server, it's a thing.
Right.
We're cool either way. So we've always been in this position to be able to expand and put our arms around this market, and the market has come to us effectively, and it's entering a really cool phase.
Right. I was doing work with automotive manufacturing, that's one of the first times I saw it. They were like, oh, we're looking at the basically the tolls, the toll, not the tolls, but the gates mm-hmm. on the production line endpoint. And that's how they measured which car's going off, the model. And we're looking at it like, wow, that's pretty cool. Because, and then we're like, how is it any different?
Yeah,
it really isn't. It's just, yeah. like I said, an item with some details.
It's an item with an item with an IP address. It can be tracked.
Yep.
And you know, and then it all kind of ties together.
So, are you guys finding that the person you're targeting in various organizations, who ends up being the ultimate decision maker on you know the purchase of your product, has that shifted? You know, from more of the tactical hands-on asset management, configuration management folks to more of the strategic, you know, vice president C level.
Actually,
are they starting to see that?
Yes, because IT has always been about managing the infrastructure, keeping the lights going effectively, and it's a very big light,
yes.
right? But it's
yeah.
it's basically keeping things going. And so, when you start moving into operations technology, that's how companies make money.
Yes,
they
Absolutely.
Manufacture cars. They yep. you know they make cookies. Whatever, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Something's but, coming out of that ship that gets shipped and sold.
But it ties IT closer to the line of business, and that's always what they've wanted.
Right.
You know, if you're tied to how they make money, you're suddenly your influence matters. You have more throw weight. So
it's amazing how important you become.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And so this is actually a great opportunity for IT. to take a more central role, and it's a good opportunity for OT to tie into a infrastructure of management that really will benefit them, because what IT does with information is frankly deeper, broader, more sophisticated than what OT does. OT is very specific to, you know, what's the wheel on my tractor look like? Is it broken? Do I need a new one?
Right.
As opposed to how does this fit into the overall production framework of how we make money?
Yeah.
So both sides win.
So have you guys been successful in helping some of your customers elevate the visibility of the value of what they provide on the asset side of the world to, you know, not only IT leadership, but business leadership?
Yeah, and that's actually, we are, you know, part of my job is to make our technology understandable to business people. So
yes.
we've been pivoting very heavily in that direction because the value is obvious. You know, right. before IT was kind of buried deep into the, you know, we do CMDBs and that's
yeah.
in the IT
yeah.
stack, and it's fairly low down. Now we're talking about, you know, production issues, and people, the business people get that because
yeah.
that's what they do. So we can suddenly contextualize our message
yeah.
and, you know, if people get what you're saying because it makes sense to them, they'll listen, and
right.
we're entering that phase now on a business level. We've
yeah.
always been good on the IT side.
Right.
Now we're getting the same kind of resonance on the business side, which is
yeah.
nice.
Yeah, that's the advice I've given to people a lot over the years is talk tech to technicians, but talk value and outcomes to leaders.
Yeah, right. exactly. And now we can actually, we have a much better story for that.
Excellent. That's good to hear.
Yeah. And that's the thing that I think a lot of us that were heavily involved in this, we always saw that, but I don't know that we always used the right terminology to express what that meant.
Yeah, sometimes it's very hard to articulate things that are very technical in nature but have a tremendous business value
yeah.
And get people to see the line of sight from the top to the bottom.
Well, the problem is, you know, if it's a technical product and it's a technical issue, the people who deal with it are deep in the weeds and
yeah,
you kind of lose perspective. And it's I see tech speak all the time and it's very easy to fall into because that's your comfort zone. And especially you go someplace like this where there's a lot of technical people.
Right. They want to get into the details.
You're in the
right.
zone. Everybody's in the zone. And then somebody comes along with an outlier and it's a big shift.
Right.
You know, so yeah, that's actually a fairly common event.
Yeah, and let's be honest, that's what they're being paid to work on.
It is.
Is the server, is the router, and that sort of thing. So
yeah.
as much
yeah.
as we say like, oh no, this impacts production, well, I'm
not
a
me.
Network.
Yeah.
yeah, I'm a network administrator.
Yeah. yeah.
Well, and that's how they're measured too. They're measured on
Absolutely.
The success of the tactical outcomes that they're driving.
Yeah. Right.
So it takes someone drawing that, again, that line of sight to the value to help them out.
Yeah, so I think again, you know, tying this to how they make money and showing, look, if you have data integrity across the operational side of your business,
right.
it makes a huge difference and we can tie it directly to the bottom line, then you get their attention.
Yeah, Agreed. Exactly.
Agree.
Well, thank you very much, Dan. As always, great speaking.
It's always a pleasure. Yeah,
yeah,
cool.
Thank you very
much.
Thank you.
Thanks.